Hello, students. Today we are going to look at a problem on the logarithm, and I have it on the board. I'll quickly read out the question. I have that solve completely for a 9 log 5 base a is equals to log 5 log a base 5. So at this point, first we are going to apply the inverse law of logarithm. I'm going to show it. It does if I have log mn. So I'm going to bring an inverse. This is the inverse. So we are going to swap this. So it's going to be log, of course, nn. So this is the inverse law of logarithm. Now I'm going to apply this here. So if I apply this here, like we have it here, it's going to be 9 times. This becomes 1 over, like we have here. So I'm going to swap this. So I have log, okay, a base 5, which is equals to log a base 5. Now we can multiply. 9 times 1 is 9, and we have log 5 or log a base 5, which is equals to still this, so log a base 5. So I haven't gotten this. So I haven't gotten this. We are going to quickly cross multiply. I can still write this as over 1. So if we cross multiply, we have 9 times 1 and log a base 5 times log a base 5. So I have log a base 5 multiplied by log a base 5. So this is going to give us, this side is 9 and log a base 5. Of course, this part looks like we're seeing m times m, which is m squared. So this is going to be log a base 5 squared. So from that, we see that 9, we can express 9. The next step, we can make 9 as a product of its prime, factors or numbers. So 9 also means 3 times what? 3. Or we can say 9 means minus 3 times minus 3, which we can write that this is 3 squared, and this is what? Minus 3 squared. So I'm going to substitute 9 here as either 3 squared or minus 3 squared. So if I do that, I have 3 squared is equals to log a base 5 squared, which is equals to minus 3 squared. So from this point, we can actually compare. I compare this equation and this equation, these two can cancel out. So I see that log a base 5 is equals to 3, or log a base 5 is equals to, let me write it here, or log a base 5 is equals to minus 3. Now from this, we are going to arrive at two answers. Now I'm going to apply. Right, so for our next step, I'm going to change to exponential equation. This I'm going to change to exponential. This I'm going to change. So if I do that, we are going to see that, of course, I have 5 will come over here. So it will take this as a power. Okay, so we'll be left with just a. 5 will come over here. So it will take this as a power. This it will take this up as an index form. So from this point, we're now going to simplify this. So I have a, this is 5 times 5 times 5, or if I use the law of indices, this is inverse of 5 is power 3. So a is 5 times 5 is 25 times 5, or I have this as 5 times 5 times 5. So our answers are, I have a is equals to this 125, or A is equals to 1 over 125. So that's the answer.